Yo, this is your boy Angel, and I'm inspired by music. Keep it locked. We feel like we're strangers. On the other hand, it makes us feel major. If they never knew, then maybe they'll name ya. Don't let them change ya. When you finally find what's beautiful, so wonderful. Yeah, the 2012's definitely wondrous. I definitely say, like, you know, the highlights for me of this year has been, like, obviously the hookup with Retch32, Gigs, Sneak Bowl. Obviously this wonderful single out now. All the festivals and stuff I've been doing. I done Wireless the other day. Done the David Hay fight the other day. I done Greece the other week. Like, three festivals coming up. This year has been amazing. But basically, I don't know. Where I'm from, people tend to stereotype you, innit? And, like, you know, I don't know for what reason, but I thought of the theory that I'm going to come up with this tune talking about, like, not really caring what anyone else thinks about me because you don't know me, especially if you don't know me. And I think everyone could appeal to that in some way because it's about having fun and being true to yourself. You was born alone, you're going to die alone. And, like, just, that's my message, really. Just not letting anyone be able to change you. And just whatever's wonderful in your vision, stay true to that. Definitely the reception's been crazy, and without the fans I don't think that it would be, I, even Angel, Suresh Charles, wouldn't be where I am right now. So it's been a lot of hard work, the team, Parallel team, the Island team, everyone's been breaking their backs, you know, getting the right place, and it's climbing, definitely. My main inspiration from is, you know, life, what's happening around me, what happened yesterday, what could happen tomorrow, you know. What I went through, what he could have went through, what, you know, things that sometimes they're not even what I've gone through, they're just situations that are appealing to the world. Yeah, definitely. I'm from Shepherd's Bush, for those of you who don't know, West London, and I mean, everything that happens, the negative, the positive, everything, like, you grasp in it and it becomes part of your horizon, your sights, and you just, like, I don't know, everything you speak, you start living it, innit? Like, everything that I've grown up around has definitely inspired me, definitely. It just comes all different ways. Sometimes I'd be putting some melody that came to my head into my iPhone, go back to where I am, think of a beat, then try and put that melody on top, or vice versa. I don't think there's any set way to be creative, to be honest with you. It just gotta come. God always just gives it. You know, just do it every day of your life. Do it, and whatever you do, make sure you put 100% in. Don't be drawn out. It's easier. It's easier to do negative than it is to do positive. There's a lot of things going on around, especially if you come from, like, neighborhoods where, like, from where I'm from and stuff. There's always gonna be things in your vision that's, you know, could lead you astray and stuff. So you just gotta be kind of, like, focused and know what you wanna do, and just think of it that the way I think of it now is, friends that I was following or that I wanted to do the same thing as, like, if they were in my position, would they kind of, like, worry about what I'm doing? Do you know what I mean? Like, friends bring you there and can't bring you back. So I'm just on the thing of, if it's in your lane and it's in your lane, everyone keep in their lane, stay in their lane. But I know what I do, and I just think that everyone needs to, what you put in is what you get out, basically. Both. I love them just the same. I love getting on the stage. I love running up and down wildly. And I love just chilling in the studio, like, under a different kind of meditation, just going into my zone. Dream collaboration. I'm going to mention two names, yeah? Definitely have to be out of Prince and Brandy. The simple fact that the whole way that I think vocally, in terms of vocal arrangements and stuff, is just straight Brandy, because she's very melodic. I've studied her albums, I've studied her for years. She's been a massive inspiration to Angel, to me, as, you know. And Prince, because of, I don't know, man, he's got a different kind of edge about him again. His progressions are sick, his song mind's wavy, and melodically and lyrically, he's out of this world. Okay, so expect something very epic, nothing too far off the 7 Minutes Before Time EP, Any Minute Now EP, for those of you who haven't heard, but just expect the same. So it's going to be very diverse. It's going to be still going to have that kind of urban edge to it, because that's where we're coming from, but it's going to be a lot more diverse, a lot more epic, you know. Feeling Adele, feeling Dappy, feeling Cleo Soul, feeling Stushy, feeling Wretch, like the list goes on. I think right now is our time, like UK's time, bro, to like come through and shine through strong and exploit what we've been holding back for so many years. All right, I've got an EP coming out in the next couple of weeks. Remember Charisse from Big Brothers? Charisse. Okay, yeah. So I've got a song with her on this EP called In Between Time. I've got our next track featuring my little brother, A-Star, and the next credible rapper from West London, Chiswick, called Sloth. And it's going to be delivered in like 2 weeks. So within that space of time, you know, there could be more, but that's the features for the minute. And the rest is just all about A. I like to chill. I'm more of a, I like lounges. I don't like to go where it's too excited, because it's just not my vibe anymore. I mean, I've been doing all the excited things from an early age, and now it's just like, whatever. There's nothing in terms of excitement that I don't think I've seen. You get what I'm saying? So I'm more like lounges. Sometimes I just like chilling at home, watching stuff like Crime and Investigation, like 48 Hours or Discovery Channel, or Netflix. I'm just like to just like chill. When you get the time to chill, I just like chilling in the most comfortable place possible. In 5 years' time, I definitely would have liked to make my mark as Angel, more than Angel, Sir Ras Charles, and just be a very credible singer-songwriter, and just keep delivering good music, and then, you know, support the next one coming up. And yeah, more than anything, for me, more than just having a number one now and worrying about a number one or how much money I'm going to make in the next year, I'm more of connecting with the mass, the masses. Do you know what? This, I'm going to say this fact because of people always ask me, and I get sick of it sometimes. Like, I don't really reckon the fans know that I produce all my own music. Do you know what I mean? Stuff to Ride Out, to Gleaming, to How Can I Lose Now. Like, I've actually written and produced, not just written. And sometimes it kind of gets me kind of frustrated, because people come up to me and be like, oh, your producers are sick. And Red's time, I'm like, but yeah, that's kind of something random that I don't think they know fully yet. But I just wanted to get that in there. And something else odd, random, that fans don't know about me, that Angel's more of a metaphor for me. Yeah, I'm not that angelic, but you know, I'm angelic. This summer I've got V Festival coming up. I'm doing a lot of stuff like in Ibiza, Greece, a lot of European shows and stuff. And the beauty about my job is, and my career and my life, is that every morning you wake up, you just never know what's going to happen. You never know what, like, you look at emails and there's just a whole new list of things happening. It's crazy. The rest of the year is just to deliver this album, deliver some more good singles, powerful singles with proper messages, as opposed to just it having a good beat or someone saying, oh, I like that beat's sick, or yeah, that was I want to do some good deliverance, good messages, good diverse beats, melodically, lyrically, and just, you know, like, build up some kind of, set some kind of waves now, man, because obviously I think that the urban's coming through hard, but it could just be a little bit more diverse to get the full epicness. And I think that's what I'm trying to work on right now. So yeah. My biggest influence musically is definitely Quincy Jones. Definitely is the genius behind Michael. All like the people that come out of Motown, Stylistics, Temptation, like everyone. And I just think, you know, obviously they've got their own genius elements, but he is just like, you said name one, and he'd be top of the list. Looking at me, when you finally find what's beautiful, so